And we are here just prior to the parade here in Oxford, downtown Oxford. It's the home of the Radio Lone Ranger Brace Beamer, and it's all about Lone Ranger days here. Great to be.
What's your name?
I'm Stephanie.
Stephanie, what are you doing?
Oh, enjoying the nice day with my family, and I'm actually looking forward to seeing the Lone Ranger. My grandmother grew up in Oxford and actually knew Brace Beamer.
Okay, so now what is your relationship to Mr. Beamer?
He was my grandfather.
And I understand that you have a lot of things that you've contributed here with pictures. And tell me how you feel about a day like this, you know, honoring your grandfather. Obviously, Oxford's been synonymous with the radio home of the Lone Ranger. How do you feel about it today? I mean, now that it's coming to fruition.
I think it's fantastic. I've been looking forward to this as soon as I heard about it.
Unbelievable. I mean, how long have you been collecting the Lone Ranger memorabilia?
My collection, roughly about 20 years.
With her, we were good friends at the farmhouse with Brace, listening to the recordings of his programs.
I remember standing behind the stable down there, and my grandfather was maybe 6 feet behind me, and Silver's Pride was coming around the paddock and came around the stable and was running directly at me. And my grandfather just stood behind me and said, "Bobby, hold your ground." And I'm terrified, as you can imagine. I'll just leave it at terrified. And I think, as best I recall it, I more or less kept my ground, squirming. But and it sounds like, oh my gosh, she's letting the stallion run at you. But they had such a connection. If you ever saw him ride, it was imperceptible the way he controlled the horse. And I'm convinced he could have winked, and the horse would have peeled off at the last moment and missed me. But it's just one.
What do we have here?
Oh, Priscilla Pandrek.
Now, what is the name of your booth here? Do you have a specific name?
No, I do not. I'm just I'm a repurpose artist.
Now, what is a repurpose artist?
Buying used things that people are discarding and giving them new life.
Giving them repurpose.
Yeah.
Hence the word repurpose artist.
Right.
You know, it just gets complicated. Yeah. And
I also had about 11 original scripts from him, and I had a sample of hairs. Of all things, from the mane of the very first horse that played Silver back in 1933.
You are a collector. I mean, more than a collector. I mean, you own a piece of history and all this stuff. I mean, I guess it's all history.
Is there any other great memories that you have about being on the air and being on the air with Brace or even, you know, the previous Lone Ranger?
Yeah. Well, I think, again, child's point of view, I was absolutely fascinated with the sound effects.
Okay.
And they were often done in the same studio. We would have a cast for a show of maybe 8 or 9 people, all, and it wasn't a very big studio. And sound effects would be off maybe in a side room. Sometimes things changed depending on the studio we were in. But, you know, it was just amazing what they did in the way of sound effects.
I'd be amazed to find out some of the things that happened, like galloping horses and stuff like that.
It was plungers in a trough of sand, you know. And so...
Just you never imagine what it could be, right?
Yeah, it was fascinating.
Do you guys want to give it a big old Oxford cheer and say, "Hey, go Lone Ranger," okay? On the count of three, we'll do that, okay? 1, 2, and 3.
Hey, go Lone Ranger!
And we didn't even rehearse that. That was all on the spot, and once again, we're going to...